Okay, hello everybody, my name is Yoga. Now, I want to explain my project about making a program for inverse kinematic analytic and simulation of Taylor's spatial frame. Taylor's spatial frame is an external fixator bone which usually using for correct and complex bone deformities. Taylor's spatial frame consists of two rings, six struts, and each strut is connected to the ring by universal joint. Because of that, Taylor's spatial frame has 6 degrees of freedom. It can move 3 translation and 3 rotation. First, I make a model of Taylor's spatial frame, include a proximal bone which purple and a distal bone which green. And then I export it using SimMechanics link to get an XML file. Okay, after get an XML file, I import it to get simulating model of my model. I use a match underscore import command. And the simulating model had been imported. Okay, in order to make my model move, I give many joint actuator, one for each strut. For example, this is strut 1 and that is the third strut, and 5, because of there are 6 struts, so I give 6 joint actuator for strut. And I also give several joint actuator in order to make model of bone deformities which attach to the ring. In the joint actuator for strut, I choose an actuator with motion, and the unit is millimeter for position, velocity, and acceleration. And the input, I give a constant block that the value is can be obtained from the result of inverse kinematic analysis that had been done from my GUI. And there are 3 inputs that we need for a position, velocity, and acceleration. And this is the code of my GUI. I give a code to test the data from the result which get from the analytic to the simulink. And then this is my simple GUI which I made. So we enter the input. The input is the direction of the bone deformities, the direction of the bone that attached to the ring, and also the dimension of the ring that we use. We enter the dimension of the ring, and then we enter how many steps we want to correct the bone. For example, we give 5 and then run. The simulink model is open and the result also is open. This is the length of leg that we need for each step to correct the bone deformities. And we can simulate it from the simulink model. We see from ZXplane. And we can choose what position that we want to see. For example, this is first position, second position, third position or third step position, fourth step position, and finally the final position. Maybe that is a simple simulation that we can see how Taylor's Tapia frame correct the bone deformities. Thank you very much.